En halv times kørsel nord for Johannesborg bor Astrid og Walter Christensen. De kom til Sydafrika i 1964 og driver en trykkerivirksomhed. Medarbejderne har vidt forskellige faglige og etniske baggrund. Astrid og Walter lever dagligdagen i et velfungerende kvarter med gode indkøbsmuligheder. Og så har de deres egen helt specielle læge, der i øvrigt kan lidt af hvert.
18 år tror jeg, vi har haft Josef her. Han var med til at bygge vores hus. Og han kom op fra Venda, det er oppe i Krygerparken. Han er en Venda. Der er mange forskellige stammer inde på de sorte jo. Så han er en Venda, og han er doktor, han er præst, plus han er min havemand. Og han kommer ind og hjælper mig hver fredag og vasker min gulv og sådan noget, og du ved, ellers så passer han haven. Og så bor han her, vi bygger et hus til ham. Og så han får hans mad, og han har det godt her. Det mener vi, han har. Og han siger, at han vil aldrig nogensinde rejse fra, så det er jo godt nok. Ja, og så han har kirkemøde hver søndag. Der er omkring 30 år i hans hus til hans gudtjeneste. Og hver dag efter klokken 5 og mellem 1 og 2, der er han doktor. Der kommer de og sidder i lange rækker herovre på bænkene og venter på, at han skal helbrede dem og hvad han ellers gør ved dem. Han er ikke heksedoktor. Han er ikke en, der tørrer det børns og sådan en af de her vitsdokker. Det er han ikke. Og når de kommer til ham med dårlig mave, og han giver dem nogle gange kok og vin og vinegar, eddike sammen, og det drikker de, og så bliver de dårlige, og så snakker han til dem, og så er der de onde ånder ud af kroppen på dem, og deres maveånder væk.
Fattigdom, overtro og en anderledes kultur gør, at mange sorte søger hjælp hos behandlere som Joseph, i stedet for hos det autoriserede sundhedssystem.
Any problem for sick, and then I take it out. Maybe sometimes the flu, ulcer, asthma, you know, I take out. Because at the time I'm taking out for the asthma or ulcer, I boil the water, and then after boiling the water, I take the soil and then to mix it with the crops out, and then to give that man or woman, and then to drink, and then to keep again. Sometimes I'm taking the hamburger tea and yogurt tea to mix it, and then to drink, and then to work inside the stomach, and then everything will be all right. Maybe sometimes he's sick, over. He lay down, and then I take the coke, and then vinegar, clear vinegar, I mixed, and then to drink afternoon and in the morning.
Patienterne besøger Joseph igen og igen, så han har lavet sit eget journalsystem på almindeligt hvidt A4-papir. Selve undersøgelsen foregik gennem samtale i de andre patienters påhør. Luften er varm og fugtig i det lille og tætpakkede lokale. Og om stearinlysene er der for hyggens skyld eller på grund af overtro, ja, det turde vi ikke spørge om. For at opnå behandling skal man medbringe en flaske cola. Og så går Joseph i gang med at blande eddike, havvand, cola og andre ikke definerede kemikalier. Og kuren har i hvert fald en effektiv virkning, nemlig at patienterne får renset maven ud. En ting er helt sikkert. Disse besøg hos en alternativ behandler har ingen som helst dokumenteret virkning over for AIDS.
Jeg ved ikke, hvor mange der at hver uge, hver dag, der dør AIDS. Men det er jo igen det, fordi at der er noget lidt med regeringen, de vil ikke rigtig tillade, at de får det der medicin, de skal have, for det er for dyrt. Det er jo også en stor fejl. Men jeg tror også, det jeg ved ikke, hvad jeg skal sige, hvor det kommer fra, det der AIDS, det er jo ikke nogen, der ved, men oppe i Afrika, det er jo endnu værre end her. Men det er forfærdeligt. Det er det virkelig. Men vi håber, at de er jo ved at finde ud af noget med, at de kan blive noget tilskud til medicin for dem. Men jeg ved ikke, om det allerede er for sent. For du mener, børn bliver født med AIDS. Små babyer har AIDS. Når de er 2 år, så dør de jo. Det er jo forfærdeligt. Og så er moren allerede død måske. Det er jo skrækkeligt.
Tracy Digger er sygeplejerske og gift med Tom, der er radiolog. Sammen har de børnene Liam og Kathleen. Begge har en travl hverdag, hvor de skal tilgodese børn, familie og en karriere i sundhedssystemet. Tracy arbejder med forskning og afprøvning af HIV-medicin. Og sammen med sin partner, Dr. Catherine Orrell, koordinerer hun afprøvningen af medicin i hele Sydafrika.
HIV is an incredibly scary disease. I wouldn't wish it on anyone, to be honest. And I think that the sooner people take or become aware of the true epidemic we're facing with HIV, I think then we can make a difference. It's so important to actually understand the problem before you start trying to treat the problem. And I think if people would acknowledge that HIV is as serious as it is in South Africa, then I think we can try and find a solution that is aimed at the population that it's meant to be aimed at. It's a very sad disease. But it's a disease where if you're prepared to make a difference, you actually can.
Vi er i Cape Town og kører af motorvej N2 forbi lufthavnen mod den township, der hedder Guguletu. Guguletu er en del af slumområdet Cape Flats, der ligger på bagsiden af Tafelbjerget. Det var her, de sorte blev samlet under apartheid, og arbejdsløshed og fattigdom præger området. Guguletu er ikke et turistmål for hvide. Her kommer man kun, hvis man har et vigtigt ærende. Vi fulgte Dr. Catherine Orrell til Guguletu Daghospital, hvor hun arbejder med et nyt projekt, der skal uddanne en gruppe behandlingsvejledere, der selv bor i området.
Well, we're here because this is a new project. It's a joint venture between a funding organization in England that's supplying us with antiretroviral therapy for 150 patients, the province that's supplying us with the space, and the other doctor that you met next door is employed by the province, and ourselves, which is the sort of research unit, the academic input. And what we're doing is trying to set up an antiretroviral treatment program in a primary healthcare setting in Africa. So we want to show, and in fact, we're also positive that we're going to show that we can actually manage antiretroviral therapy adequately with far beyond ordinary standard virological suppression and adherence to therapy from a primary healthcare setting. The big sort of feather in our cap are the treatment counsellors, who are themselves all HIV positive and who are all on therapy and who have been trained as counsellors and support personnel to support our 150 patients on treatment. At the moment we have 6 counsellors employed, by the end we'll have about 10, and they will each have 15 patients for whom they are personally responsible. We're also seeing a number of patients who were screened 2 weeks ago who are coming now for their bloods, for their CD4 counts, their viral loads, and they will sign today an agreement, which is an agreement between us and them, between the council and them, or myself and them, whoever signs a piece of paper, just to basically say we will supply them with antiretroviral therapy, we will supply them with information about therapy, and we will supply them with support in terms of adherence. We will provide clinical care, I will examine you, we will take blood to make sure that things are safe, so that we will give you treatment and we will also make sure that it's safe, okay. We will talk to you about the medications and educate you, and I'm sure you have missed a bit of that without Nomoroma, but you need to learn a little bit about the medications, okay. And we will support you in staying on treatment. And all those things are what we agree to give to you. But in return, we're going to be taking things from you back, okay? So we want you to take your medications as we prescribe. It's very, very important that you take these medicines every day, okay? Because these medicines don't take the virus out of your body. They're not a cure, as you know. They just push the virus down, and it's like putting a lid on the pot. We have a short meeting every morning. We have a longer meeting on it. We're presently running part-time, 3 afternoons a week, and that's because this clinic gets quiet in the afternoon so we can have these rooms. In the morning, it's busy. So we all sort of congregate at about 1:30. Our patients are booked for 2:00. And we just discuss issues, problems, things that have arisen. Ask them if they've had any problems with their home visits and visiting their patients. Has anyone contacted them? We've got some patients on drug. Have they had any problems? And before we move on to the day's new and repeated patients. We call them adherence monitors, and they've been trained to help people stay on therapy, because with antiretroviral therapy, ideally, you need to achieve an adherence of 95% to medication. So that's missing less than one dose a month, one dose in every 6 weeks or so. We need more medication. We need more money for staff and that kind of thing. We need to be opening clinics in all the districts, not just this one. But I mean, I think if we can show that it can be done, we're doing a very important thing, not just for these 150 patients, but also more broadly. It's a challenge. It's a big challenge. Turning people away is heartrending. It's horrible. But we see patients who are too ill to start therapy, who are basically brought in a wheelchair, who are pre-terminal, and who this therapy is not going to do anything for. And they come to you and you are their very last hope, and you say sorry, and that's horrible. And because of the state of the epidemic at the moment, we've had quite a few of those pre-terminal people. In fact, 2 of our patients have died in the last few weeks. People that we thought were okay and we screened, you know, not even the people we said no to, people that we actually screened have died, because we're starting off and we really are dropping a drop into an ocean of illness. And the doctors that refer us patients send us their desperately ill patients that they're stuck with, and we have to turn them away. And that's quite harsh. So it is a challenge, but we'll get there. We'll get there. Yeah.
Hush, hush, hush! Hush, hush, hush! Hush, hush, hush!
Hush, hush, hush!
Hush, hush, hush!
Hush, hush, hush!
Hush, hush, hush!
Hush, hush, hush!
Hush, hush, hush!
Hush, hush, hush!
Hush, hush, hush!